It was more than 35 years old.
There was some DNA evidence that came back that linked him to the crime.
But DNA collected after Ronda Blaylock's death had been perfectly preserved, and since 1980, science had made some major strides.
The evidence that they had for it to still be able to be used and analyzed was amazing. I mean, technology has come so far. Even I think when they first started doing DNA, it wasn't as good as it is now.
On August 2nd, 2019, an email from the Surrey County Sheriff's Office titled Robert James Adkins.
They had actually called him after all these years. I mean, that's kind of unbelievable.
An arrest in the 1980 murder of Ronda Michelle Blaylock, a picture of a gray-haired man, bearded, mouth open, and in overalls, standing nearly 6 feet tall. It was a Friday, and a year to the day after Rhonda's mother, Lynn, passed away.
I was leaving work, and my daughter called me, and I just started crying.
News proliferated through the Piedmont, reaching Rhonda's family.
I still have not seen him, and I would love to just see what kind of evil that is, you know, what kind of, just to see what he looks like.
And to Adkins' family. His first cousin, Becky Finney, still remembers when she heard of Rhonda's murder.
It was hard for me to believe. And I didn't realize that he was accused of it until years later.
Her brother, Billy Whitaker, had seen news of the arrest on the Fox 8 6 o'clock news and called Becky. They called Adkins by his middle name, James, and Billy revealed that deputies had been looking into Adkins very, very early in the investigation.
But there was a deputy sheriff in Stokes County. I ain't going to mention no names. It's been years ago. He told my sister-in-law that they knowed who done it, or they had a suspicion who done it, but they didn't have the DNA then that they got now. So, and he told exactly who he thought it was.
What'd he say?
James Adkins.
4 days later, Surrey County Sheriff Steve Hyatt walked into a conference room and, with members of the Ronda Blaylock Task Force behind him, spoke the words Ronda's family waited nearly four decades to hear.
The man responsible for these crimes is behind bars.
With Ronda's family there, still dazed, relieved expressions on their faces, embracing.
I hope this arrest will bring you some type of resolve.
The irony that the announcement of the arrest came a year after Lynn's death, not lost on her sister, Vicky.
From beyond, she got it. That was a given. She said, this is the day. 1 year from when she passed. She said it was time.
But there were rumblings that the case against Adkins had been made long before the announcement of his arrest, and part of the task force says Lynn knew it.
Her mother became terminally ill, and she didn't want a lot of press in her front yard and things like that. And she didn't want a media circus in her front yard. They respected her wishes.
Now the rest of the family had a face and a name to whom they could direct their ultimate question.
What made him decide to do what he did to change so much, so many people's futures by one decision? And why couldn't he just let her go? Why couldn't he just let her go?
A question even those who share DNA with Adkins are unable to answer a half year after his arrest.
The only thing I could think of is alcohol and drugs. Now, I don't know if he was involved in drugs or not, but if he did do it, something happened that night.
Now, Ad-